Hi, I'm Sundata Yet Villarreal Jr. Welcome to Video Assisted Instruction Computer Programming 1 series. Right now is our lecture number 11. So the topic is conditional statement part 4. So let's proceed with the two-way selection. Sometimes desirable for a statement to be executed when logical expression is considered to be false. So if we have a statement 1, it goes directly to the logical expression, which is the decision. On the right, we have true, and on the left, we have false. Then it will go down to the end of the program. The same process in the false statement 3. It will goes to the end of the program. So this is what you call the two-way selection. If you choose true, then it will go to the statement 2 and go to the statement 4. If you choose false, it will go to the statement 3 and it will go to the statement 4. Two-way selection with if. Possible to use combinations of if. Statement 1, if logical expression, then statement 2, then another if logical expression, then statement 3, and it will go to the statement 4. So the reason of this is considered to be, if you want to make it more accurate in terms of the decision making. But it should be identified right here, but not efficient. Not efficient in the terms of redundancy. You have the decision first and the second decision is still going on. But you will notice here, they uses not in the logical. So remove not and it will be efficient. Now, if else statement. So we have syntax. If logical expression right here, true statement A. Else, it will go to statement B. The idea here is that every time that the if statement is considered to be logically expression true or correct, so it should be always true in a statement A. Otherwise, if it is false, it will go to else. Then the statement B will proceed. Find max with if else. Integer, find max int num1, comma int num2. So we have two variable, num1 and num2. So we have integer big as the third variable. So find max is a function call. And this variable, num1 and num2, are inside of the findMax function call. Now, big is equal to num1. If num2 is greater than num1, then big is equal to num2. So, we have here, if the decision is considered to be true from num2 is greater, then big is equal to num2. Next, we have integer findMax in num1 and num2. Integer big, the same. But if num2 is greater than num1, then big is equals to num2. Else, if it is false, it will go to big is equals to num1. Now, which is best upon this two if-else statement? I go for the second part because this is complete. Next, using if-else for robustness. It meant to say very clear, very accurate in timing. So, this is the code which is in a very good condition. Float. Calc average float sum. It means to say a decimal point when we identified float. And sum is the variable. So integer count is a variable also. If count is exactly equal to 0, then return 0.0. Else returns sum divided by count. This is direct and it will return 0.0. It means to say this is more faster because if you identify it as true, then it is returning 0.0. And if it's false, it will return also the sum divided by count. It means to say the number divided by count. Now, to return statement for each condition, compile the statement and if else. If function with year %4 divided by 4 getting its remainder, and that is what you called modulo, is equals to 0. Begin printf, it will display on the screen leap year, then num days is equals to 366. Else, if it is wrong, so we have printf, not a leap year, then num days is 365. Remember, printf, it will display on the screen, but this num days is not because it is not indicated on the printf. Programming tip, compound statement. Does not hurt to always use compound statement for if-else statement. If logical expression, statement, or statement. Would be if logical expression, statements only. else statement. Now, easy to add statements later. Programming tip. When we said indenting, to make the code more clear, it is also identified as beautification of the code. Indent statement in function definition to clearly identify body of function. Indent statements executed for if by fixed amount 2 to 3 characters every time. For ifs, within an if, indent further. Indent else statements similarly may want to make open and close curly braces matches on the parentheses as separated lines. Programming tip, conditions, code most likely conditions first. Second, code positive conditions where possible. Code parts of solution executed most often first. It means to say, every time you code, the result of that is the solution to the problem. That's all for today. Thank you for watching and good luck. Congratulations to successfully finish our lecture number 11.